Hello everyone, welcome to another video from City Self-Sufficiency. My name is Lauren and I wanted to go through some of the questions I've been getting recently about mealworms. These are the ones that I get most often, so I thought I'd pop them all together in one lot just to cover as much information as possible. So without further ado, here are my top 10 mealworm questions. Do they feel slimy? No. Mealworms actually feel a bit like tiny snakes, which probably doesn't do much to tempt most people to pick one up. But they feel smooth and dry and solid and shiny and surprisingly strong for their size. Do mealworms bite? Again, no. Both mealworms and their adults only have very weak little jaws that aren't really strong enough or large enough to give you even the slightest nip. They might try, just to see if you're edible, but neither the worms nor the beetles can bite. Can you really eat them? Yes, you really, really can eat mealworms. If anything, insects are becoming more and more popular as a food source. There's a real upsurge at the moment looking at alternative protein sources. We've seen in the news and we know how much damage we're currently doing to the planet in terms of our eating habits, so insects are becoming a much more sustainable food source, especially in comparison to something like cows. And of course, one of the main benefits of them is that they're something your average person can raise at home, which is a massive money saver. Obviously, if you're currently thinking about starting your own colony with a look to eating them yourself, you need to make sure that you're cooking them before you eat them, and I'm in the process of putting together a video at the moment showing how to do that, or certainly at least how I do that. But they can be eaten either whole, sort of heads, tails, legs and all, or if you don't like the idea of that, they can be chopped up, mixed up into other recipes, they can be used to create meatballs and burgers, that sort of thing. But ultimately, yes, you can eat them. Will they escape? They shouldn't do, not so long as you've given them a ventilated plastic tub to live in that has nice smooth sides that's more than 3 inches above the surface of their substrate. They shouldn't be able to climb up and escape. Mealworms can actually barely climb. They're not the sort of creature that tries to escape very actively, so as long as they've got food and bedding to bury themselves in, they're usually pretty content to just stay put. What can I feed my worms? One of the best things about mealworms is that they will eat all sorts of things. Any vegetable matter you've got, stalks, peelings, apple cores, banana peel, anything like that. Tops and tails from carrots or parsnips, like the outside leaves from a cabbage. Anything vegetably that you wouldn't eat will be absolutely perfect for them. Remembering that they always need to have something vegetably in with them, as it's where they get their water from, so you should always provide them with something sort of vegetable nature. They'll also eat anything cereal based, so if you've got bread, tortillas, wraps, pasta, rice, bagels, anything like that that you've got left over, you can give that to them. You just need to be a little bit careful not to give them something that's too big. So, for example, if you wanted to give them apple cores or anything, it's better to cut it into smaller chunks so that they can easily get to it, rather than leaving it as some huge great lump that you've just chucked in with them. Also, going back to their weak little jaws, they do find it much easier to eat vegetables from the inside out, rather than having to get through the skin. So if you're giving them carrots or anything like that, for example, as long as you've cut it up into small pieces, they should be able to sort of like start from the softest bit and work their way out. Can the beetles fly? Adult beetles certainly do have wings, but they can't fly because the two sides of their carapace, that's a sort of shiny black covering on their body, they fuse together down the side so that the wings are effectively trapped underneath. Sometimes if you find ones that haven't managed to pupate properly, you can actually see bits of the wings poking out, but even these ones won't be able to take to the air. They don't have the mechanical means to spread their wings, so they're essentially ground-based. Of all the animals in the world, why do you keep mealworms? I actually really like them. I think they are underrated, fascinating little creatures. I love watching them grow bigger and bigger, from almost these microscopic teeny tiny little dots into big fat healthy worms, and then the transformation from worm to beetle to me, you know, is just as miraculous as it is for a caterpillar turning into a butterfly. So I just like them. What about if I want to go on holiday? Everyone needs to take a break every now and again, and you might be worried about leaving this colony that you've spent so long nurturing. But truthfully, so long as they're clean and you give them some food that will last, then you can leave them for a couple of weeks without really setting them back at all. Out of necessity, I've had to leave my colonies completely alone for a week with absolutely no one looking after them, and they've been fine. The biggest killer for mealworms is excess moisture. They can actually survive for a long time in a completely dry environment. If you want to go on holiday, you can just leave the worms for a couple of weeks in their bedding, which remember should be something edible like oats or wheat bran or cereals, and then just give them a carrot or two to munch on and they'll be just fine. What not to feed them? The biggest no-no with sort of feeding your mealworms is don't give them anything that is rotting or too fluid. The last thing you want is liquids building up at the base of the tub because the worms can drown quite easily. Also, don't give them our sort of processed food. Don't give them chips, pizza, that sort of thing. It'll just rot, and even if they do eat it, it won't do them any good, much the same as it probably didn't do you any good. Also, don't give them any meat. They're vegetarian, they should be fed greens. Also, don't give them anything that's too hard. They won't eat very stale bread, for example. If it's reached that point where you can sort of tap it on a table and then use it as a frisbee, they're not going to be able to chew on it. At best, they'll use it as something to hide under. Are mealworms the same as superworms? Yes and no. Yes, both superworms or Moria worms are types of darkling beetle, so they have very similar diets and they pupate to become a shiny black beetle, and both of them like to be kept in the dark. But equally, no. Morios are much, much bigger and they have a slightly warmer temperature requirement as they come from a more tropical climate. And they also need quite a different setup if you're looking to breed them. They need something that's a bit more specialised. Other than that though, yes, they are pretty much the same in terms of how you keep them and want to feed them. You can in fact keep Morios in with your mealworms if you wanted to keep them in the same tub, and the two will quite happily cohabit. I hope this video has maybe helped answer some of the sort of side questions you might have had around keeping mealworms, but if not, then feel free to ask me anything in the comments below and I'll get back as soon as I can. But thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye bye!